Amen, amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to celebrate the life of Mayme Lee Johnson. Church say amen. We were able to celebrate even the time of difficulty, a time that may have tears shed. We can celebrate because of the precious promise we have through Jesus Christ. We can celebrate because a long time ago she made a choice to make Jesus her Savior and Lord. Amen. And with that choice came a promise. With that choice came a blessed assurance, amen, that after this life, there was more life to come. And so we're here today really not dealing with the period, but just dealing with the comma. Because when you have that comma, you're transitioning to another place. And so as we gather today to celebrate this life and to encourage this family, we'll begin just by singing a song, a great hymn of the church, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation and purchase of God, born of his spirit and washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. At this time, we will call for the directors to come, amen. And we'll allow for the family to have their viewing, for those who so desire to have their viewing before the close. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. Oh, this is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I am my Savior, am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above. Launching his wilderness, lost in his love. Oh, this is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Oh, this is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Praising my Savior all the day long. Praising my Savior all the day long.
Church, say amen. Church, say amen. The scripture says in all things to give thanks. How can we give thanks, Reverend, in all things when things are difficult and trying? Because he is our blessed assurance. Amen. We can give thanks because the word declares that while everything may not feel good, it says that all things work together for the good of those that love him and are called according to his purpose. Amen. Amen. So as we continue in this celebration, the song of celebration this morning will be brought to us by Maya White. Amen. As she encourages us in song, let us praise God for her. Amen.
Not a second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. I need you now, I need you now, I need you now, I need you now. Not another second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If I've never needed you before, to show up and restore all of the faith that I let slip while I was yet searching the world for more, the truest friend I have indeed. You're my best friend, I know in need. I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. The agony of being alone, fear of doing things on my own, the tests and trials that come to make me strong. The ways of trials that beat upon me, but to know, Lord, that in you I've got victory. Yeah. I need you now, Lord, I need you now. Oh, I need you right now, right now, right another day.
I need you now. Thank you, Sister Maya, for even ministering through the hurt. Amen. We need you now, Lord. This time in our celebration, we'll have our morning invocation, our prayer for the family. Amen. By retired Pastor Jerry Hatter. If he comes now, let us praise God for him. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Truly, we need him now, like never before. As we gather today, thank God for this Pastor Phillips and to the family and to all of you, my sun-kissed sisters and brothers in Christ. We thank you for this opportunity, and we say to the family, God be with you. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all of the rest of us, God of grace and glory, God of our weary years, and our silent tears, the God of creation, God of salvation, God like no other God, we look to you now in times like these. God, we need you at this hour. God, have your way. Have thine own way. In this place, not only in this place, but in our hearts and in our spirit, oh God. And God, as we journey through this valley, hallelujah, even the valley of the shadow of death, God, we know that you are with us. You are Emmanuel, and it is well with our soul. It is well with our hearts, and God, even as we go through these difficult days and these trying times, we know that you are with us. And so, Lord God, we pray your peace and your power and your presence, God, will fill this place, not only this place, oh God, but fill our souls and fill our hearts and fill us, oh God, until we overflow, till our cup runneth over. God, we need you. We thank you. God, we praise you. We pray your power and your presence, your anointing. God, we pray that you will keep this family in perfect peace. Their minds be stayed on you. God, we pray for this daughter and granddaughter and the rest of the family. And we pray, oh God, for all of us, that Lord God, we know what they are going through, because hardly anyone in this room has no idea what this kind of day is like. So Lord God, help us to draw closer, closer to you, closer to each other. Help us to live, move, and have our being. In the name of Jesus, we love you today. God, we praise you today. We pray that you will walk with us, guide us and guard us and govern us and give us this day, hallelujah, our daily bread. God, we need bread now. Bread of heaven, feed us till we want no more. We need you now, Lord. We need you right away, Lord. Come, Holy Spirit, heavenly dove, with all your quickening power. Feed us and lead us in the name of Jesus. This is our prayer. God, we are praying it in faith, believing that you are granted in grace to the glory and honor of your name. We ask it in Jesus' name. God's people declared it. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen, amen. This morning we are grateful and thankful for a faith in the family. Amen. This is a family, and the Johnson's family, White family, have been connected for a long time. Amen. And so we praise God for faith in the family and for one who's coming now, Reverend Dr. Ronald White, to share the scriptures of comfort, amen, with us. And we welcome you and bless you, sir. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Seems like we've been here way too many times. But God is still ever merciful. Our scriptures today come from a familiar passage, the 23rd number of Psalms for our Old Testament reading. It reads as follows. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I currently walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Our New Testament reading comes from 1 Thessalonians. Chapter 4, verses 13 down through verse 18. Paul writes this to the church and to us. He says, but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not precede them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Yeah, yeah. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Thus reads the word of God for the people of God.
This time we'll have the reading of the obituary by Sister Emily Jones.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, family. Mayme Lee White Johnson was born in Ypsilanti, Michigan on July 14, 1944 to the late Connie Mae Williams White and Charlie White after her family migrated to Ypsilanti, Michigan from Belton, South Carolina. She departed this life on Saturday, April 2nd, 2022, surrounded by her loving family in the comfort of her home in Ypsilanti, Michigan. Mayme attended public school in Ypsilanti, Michigan and graduated from Willow Run High School in 1962. She took classes at both Cleary Business College and Eastern Michigan University. She later earned an associate degree from Washtenaw Community College in Business Administration. Mayme was united in holy matrimony to the late Ralph Johnson of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Of this union, they had one daughter, Jada Louise Johnson. Mayme was a longtime member of Brown Chapel AME Church, where she was a faithful member down through the years. She enjoyed a various and illustrious career. She worked as secretary for various professionals at the University of Michigan School of Law. As a scheduler for the former Chrysler Corporation in Ann Arbor, and she was an office assistant at Park Ridge Community Center, City of Ypsilanti. She also was secretary with the Washtenaw Livingston County Substance Abuse Prevention Coordinating Agency. Mayme retired from the Ypsilanti Township Neighborhood Watch Program, where she served as program coordinator. She enjoyed assisting members in the community by providing resources to keep them well informed of various events and safety measures. She developed a close relationship with five of her former co-workers from Washtenaw County: Helen DeNoia, Marie Irwin, Edna Mickelson, yours truly, Emily Jones, and Cheryl Ashford Wilson, who called themselves the Lunch Bunch and met on a regular basis to have lunch, reminisce, and catch up with each other on their lives. Mayme really enjoyed connecting with them after her retirement and eating at Red Lobster, her favorite restaurant. She never brought home leftovers and always had a great time with the girls. Mayme leaves to cherish her precious memories, her loving daughter, Jada Louise Johnson, grandson, Jaden Lance Johnson, granddaughter, Jayla Marie Johnson, loving sister, Geraldine Jerry White, and a host of nieces, nephews, cousins, and friends. She was preceded in death by her parents, Charles and Connie Mae White, brothers J.C., Alvin, Wiley, Charles, Michael, and James, sisters Eugenia Fuller, Ruby McCoy, Connie Marie, and Maxine.
Thank you. Our opportunity of our service now to be able to share in remarks, to welcome family and friends, those who may have words of comfort or encouragement, a smile, a memory, a story that you want to share in this time. If that be the case, we just invite you to come to the podium and to give remarks and share.
Thank you. I'm going to miss Mom. And I guess at the end, you start thinking about the beginning. You know, I just think about all the times me and Jacob was in the basement, roller skating, maybe yelling out there, be quiet. You know, just a quick little story. I was telling my wife, and I think I told you, and I told Jay, I'm gonna make this quick. Mayme used to always tell me something, and I don't know if she spoke this to any of the other nephews in the family, but Mayme would always tell me, she told me this since I could barely walk. You my favorite horse. If you never win a race. Y'all ever heard? You ever heard that? Okay. So it was just me. And I just understood what she was saying. This was shortly before she passed. You know, God has spared me to be here 50 years. He spared the life of a fool. And I woke up and told my wife, you know, I just understood what she was really saying. And all that time, I didn't understand. Mayme was basically telling me, I believe in you, even when you don't believe in yourself. And that was just the type of little stuff Mayme would do. Mayme wouldn't necessarily tell you directly. She just kind of hang it out there and leave it for you to go get it. This was just a testament to who she was as a person. And I love her for that. And me and my daughter, we're going to go see her shortly before she going to get released from the hospital. And I couldn't get in because they had changed policies due to COVID. I said, I gotta get over there. I gotta tell her this. And before I could do it, she was gone. But I'm gonna miss her. I love her dearly. And I'm gonna try to be her favorite horse from here on out. I love you, Mayme. God bless y'all. Thank you.
And as the sister comes, I just want to encourage you, brother, that she heard you, amen, that she heard you. And so those stories that God gives and those words that he gives, those messages that after a while they begin to make sense. I know there's a song that says we'll understand it better by and by. So thank you for sharing that with us, amen.
Nobody can take her place and never will. I'm going to miss her very much. And each and every day, I'm going to think about she's not gone. She just resting. But she's in a better place. I love her so much. She went away too soon. She didn't even tell me she was leaving. But things happen. I'm going to miss her very much. Like I said, no one, I don't care who you are, you cannot take her place. And don't ever think you can, because you will not make it.
Amen. Ooh, can't nobody take her place. You're right about that. I was doing pretty good. I was doing really good. I was doing really good. And then two things happened. There was a picture came up that showed all the brothers and sisters that went home. And I was cool with that. And then the obituary was read and their names were called off. And that hurt. It hurt because everybody has a different memory of Mayme. Mine's a little different. You know, when I got here, she was already here. And the way I remember Mayme is there's a picture that scrolls by where she has a little afro and Jada has her pigtails looking like she don't want to be in the picture. But that picture reminds me of who I remember Mayme as being, defiant. Not necessarily angry, but this, you know, I am who I am. You can love me or like me, but I really don't care. And you know, that's how she always presented herself to me. And when I got grown, you know, 50, 60 years old, she would remind me of my place or where I stood in her eyesight. She would always say, boy, I used to change your diapers. That was her way of humbling me and reminding me that, you know, she was here already when I got here, and the things that I think I already know, she's already been through and gone through and recovered from them. So I thank her, though, for the wisdom that she possessed. I thank her for the love that she showed the way she showed it. I thank her for the things that she passed on to her daughter. Because if you see Jada, you do see Mayme.
Oh, yeah.
Act like her, talk like her. Pastor, I'm sorry to say this, but she'll pull out a knife and cut you like her too, but you know. Hey. Yeah, okay. But the thing is, I just wanted to say my appreciation, not only for her, but again, all her brothers and sisters that have gone on. Ooh, we've got some. Their fathers, uncles, brothers, sisters. And then I like the way the last remaining one got up, where Jerry got up. Jerry surprised me because she showed some strength and some backbone, and basically stated, you know, I miss her. I'm a little mad at her that she didn't say goodbye to me, but I know where she is. And if the rest of us can have that same attitude, maybe we're mad at you that you didn't say goodbye to us, but I know where you're at. And I plan to see you again, along with the rest of my family. So family, simply just be encouraged. We've been through this before. And each time we thought we wasn't going to make it, we did. Through the grace of God, who says, when he says, my grace is sufficient, it surely is. And we've learned it through the years. We've learned it from our songs, through our ministry, through just visiting one another. And we don't have to do it all the time, but we know who we are, and we know how we love each other, and we know that if we call on one another, somebody's going to show up, because that's what family does. So rest well, Mayme. Stay strong, family. And we will see the rest of them again, if we only believe.
Give honor to God, to the pastor, family, and friends. As it was stated, I'm part of the Lunch Bunch, and I work with Mayme at Public Health Department. And Mayme made it a joy to come to work.
You know, we got together, we talked, we did our work, but we had fun doing it. And then even after we retired, like they said, we would meet regularly and have lunch and talk about what we're doing, you know, who's been on vacation, where they're going, talk about the kids, the grandkids and everything. And on the day that Mayme passed, a few of us got together. Helen called me. She said, "Sure, well, I'll go see Mayme." And I said, "Okay, well, just leave a message on my machine because I have to work. But, you know, tell me what time, and I'll try to be there." So we went, and Jada said, "You know, Mamie's been sleeping a long time. You know, Mama's been asleep." So we were there in the room with her, and I was standing at the foot of the bed. And I said, "Mayme," I said, "Jada said you done been asleep long enough. Wake up." And so we were standing there, and she opened up one eye. And I said, "Cheryl, wake up." And she opened up the other eye, and she looked, and she looked around, and she saw the rest of us there. And I think she stayed awake maybe about 3 minutes looking at, you know, just looking. And then she closed her eyes. And then later that day when I got home, Helen called me. And said she passed. "Jada, thank you so much for allowing us to be here. It means so much to us. Thank you. God bless you, and I'm praying for you." Thank you.
I want to thank everybody for being here first. Because if you call my grandma, she'd either tell you I was doing good or I was doing bad. But I knew my grandma was getting old because she used to drive me around everywhere. Then I had to start driving her around everywhere. She called me late at night. "Jan, can you take me to the store?" "Of course, grandma, I'll take you to the store. You know what I called to ask me?" And I want to thank my grandma for all the love she showed me and my sister and my mom. I want to thank my mom for being so strong for me, because strongest woman I know, being there for me and my sister. At the same time, I couldn't imagine the pain she was going through. But I did everything I can to be there for her as well. One story I want to tell from my grandma. I love her so much, and she was so impatient. My grandma would come to school to pick me up an hour before everyone got there, before school even let out. So she's sitting in the car doing crossword puzzles. She saw every page. I was like, "Mommy, you going to throw that book away?" "No, I still got a couple more pages left." "All right." So I go to tutoring one day. My sister decided, "Oh, I'm going to leave on time. Damn, I'm in school for an hour longer than what I'm supposed to be." So she go out there and tell, "Oh, grandma, we can just go home. We can leave Jane at the school." "What?" So my sister, she left her phone at school. I didn't bring my phone with me. So now we got a situation. She don't got her phone. She at home. My grandma, she left me at school, stranded me there. So I called grandma. I was like, "Grandma, why'd you leave me here?" "Boy, you was taking too long." "I tried to let you know. I thought Jayla was going to let you know." So, that happened. I was too mad about it because she'd been doing it for years, since middle school, elementary. So, she got tired. I would have been tired too. But thank y'all again. I appreciate it.
Hello, everybody. I haven't known Ms. Johnson that long. Thanks to her daughter, Jada, I was allowed to hang out with them. And it was epic time, epic moment. She said whatever came to her mind. She just told you how she felt. But what I love about this celebration, you don't hear all this whooping and hollering and screaming. That lets you know everybody made peace with her. Everybody loved her. And it's a difference between a funeral and a homegoing. This is a homegoing. This is a celebration of life. This is not a funeral. And I know it's really the right thing when people say when their loved ones die or the, whoever giving the eulogy or whatever, they're in a better place. And that's true when you're a believer in Christ, when you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. That's true. We know this about her. She accepts Jesus as Lord and Savior. So it's a true statement. So I appreciate people that give that statement and it's accurate. Because everybody, when they make their final transition, don't be in a better place. I'm just being real about it. That's truly, I got to be honest about it. But we know it's true for her. And really, the homegoing or funeral is for the people that's living. It's for us to get out, show you that they done made their final choice. Their time is up. They, hopefully with the Lord. Because it says absent from the body, present with the Lord. If you're a believer in Christ. Well, thank God. She with the Lord. So, for those that want to see her again, you got time to get it right. If you ain't at peace with God, you need to patch it up. Because this is time to do that. That's what this is for. It's for us. She looking down, smiling, looking at all of us, saying, wow, these are people that love me. I only known her for a short period of time, but I got a chance to get to meet her, have some laughs with her, and I really can say I love her. And hey, now it's time for us. She left the legacy with her family. And it's just time for us to get ourselves together so we can see her again. Thank you.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Praise the Lord. I just wanted to say that I praise God for knowing Mayme. The scripture also tells us that in all things we are to give thanks. And I give thanks today that the Lord allowed me to have relationship with Mayme. And I thank Mayme for babysitting for me. Between Jada and Emerald and Faith, the three musketeers, they were always together. And Faith would always say, can I go to Jada? Sure. They spent many a night together. And Mayme seems to have enjoyed the kids. She's a great mom. And like you said, she was very blunt. You didn't have to worry about where you stood because she would always tell you. And I'm proud because she told me several times. We didn't spend a lot of time together, but some of the times we did spend together, she did tell me that she loved me. And I loved her too. And I just want the family to know that I love you. And I remember so many things about, I call you the Harriet Street crew. The whole family there on Harriet Street. And mom and all of them, and I'll always remember. Went to school with Wiley and Janice, and I remember when they tied the knot, all that. There's a lot of great memories. Right now, you'll shed tears, but there'll come a time when you'll think, and the joy and the smile will come across your face. You remember all the wonderful times you had. And how great it was to have a big family. I only had two brothers, little bitty family. But it seems like the big families have so much fun, you know? So you'll think about the good times that you had. I'm praying for you, I love you, and God bless you.
Amen.
We praise God and we thank God for this opportunity just to reflect and reminisce and to recount the many things in life that this life does. And so we bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Amen. And yes, weeping may endure for the night, but I declare joy will come in the morning. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. And we need strength for this hour. So I want to speak to the family just briefly to say you were blessed. Amen. For the love, the life, and the legacy of our dear sister Mayme. And she was such a joy, and she was faithful in her attendance and faithful being a foundational sort of setting for the family in many ways. And so I certainly have truly enjoyed all the times that we shared and with this family and with the whole family. And it's just a wonderful thing, as the brother said, this homegoing celebration. So let us continue to live a life of celebration. Amen. Every time we the mention of a name, it ought to be a moment of celebration. Every time you think about all that she's done for you and us, and it's just a time to celebrate the goodness of the Lord, yes, while we are yet in the land of the living. And so continue to reflect. God gives us a memory. Amen. And that memory will renew the strength and the blessings that God has given us to know what he has done down through the years. He's been good. Amen. He's been good. So we thank God for the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. God bless you. God keep you. May his face continue to shine on you and give you his peace. Amen.
Before we have the letters of tribute, letters and tributes in resolution, just want to take a moment to share and to say I did not get a chance to know your mother. Amen. But over the last few months here, as was shared in the transition, the passing of your uncle, had a chance to speak with you. And I believe it is true that good fruit comes from a good tree. Amen. And just the interactions and conversations with you, not only as one who was caring for your uncle and also caring for your mother in that time. And some of you all may not remember, but Jada couldn't come at that time, even with her own health. Amen. And so just for his strength in you, and also as a mother, to talk to you as a parent, we've got five, amen, we've got five coming up. And I was just talking to Jaden out in the hallway about what's next. And so just want to know that, let you know that Brown Chapel is here, amen, to be a support, glory be to God. I know you got more support because you got preachers in the family and ministers, praise God, but Brown Chapel is here. The same way they was here for your mother, they will be here for you all. And you may not know it yet, amen, because we're new to you all. But as you all grow, just know there is a support and persons that want to see you all thrive, amen, and to encourage you in this journey, because we all need somebody. Somebody say amen. And there's nothing like knowing there's a place of encouragement, a place where you'll get some sound, insight, and most of all, prayer. And so we are praying for all of you that God would continue to strengthen you and bless you in this season, amen. Amen. This time we'll have our letters, again, letters and tributes and resolution. And praise God for our steward pro tem, Sister Carolyn James. Let's just say amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. To the family, may the peace of God comfort you. Over the days, the weeks, the months, and the years, may the memories of Sister Mamie bring you joy, laughter, and blessings. And always remember that the White family is a legacy here at Brown Chapel. This is your home, and you're always welcome. As Pastor said, if we can do anything for you, reach out to us. We're here for you. So God bless you. I have a few cards here. There are more out in the Northex, but we're just going to read about three or four this morning. In a place full of light, full of grace, Jada and the family, may it bring you some peace to know that the one you love knows only peace now, thinking of you with sympathy. So sorry for the loss of your mother. My condolences to you and the family. Love, Pat. In the loss of your mother, our mothers departed, but never their love and never the lessons they've taught us, never their guidance, never their blessings, never the joy they brought us. Dear Jada and family, thinking of you as you celebrate her memory, as you mourn her loss, may God grant you comforting comfort during this very difficult time. Love, Emily J. Keeping you close in caring thoughts and prayers. Though your heart must feel deep sadness at the loss of the one you love, may it also hold the blessings of the life you shared and the love that will always be a part of you. Praying that God will comfort your heart, uplift your spirit, and carry you through this time of sadness to a place of peace. With the deepest sympathy, Dion A. Kennedy and family. With sympathy, to the family of Mamie Johnson, thinking of you and the family in the loss of your loved one, with the sympathy and understanding that words can only try to express, our sincere condolences, love, Larry and Laverne Somerville. The family expresses their sincere thanks for your effectual fervent prayer, phone calls, encouraging cards, delicious food, and all other acts of grace shown to them. May the Lord repay you for your kindness. Ruth, 2nd chapter, verse 12. May the members of Brown Chapel who are present today please stand with me as I read this resolution to the family. Brown Chapel African Methodist Episcopal Church, 1043 West Michigan Avenue, Ypsilanti, Michigan. Resolution. God blesses those who patiently endure testing and temptation. Afterwards, they will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love him. James 1, verse 12, the New Living Translation. Whereas our Heavenly Father received from labor to rest Mamie Lee Johnson on Saturday, April 2nd, 2022. Whereas Sister Mamie Johnson was a loving mother, grandmother, sister, friend, and a member of Brown Chapel African Methodist Episcopal Church. Whereas Sister Mamie worked and served in various capacities in the Ypsilanti area and made great friends along the way. Whereas Sister Johnson's faith in God and in Jesus Christ as her Lord and Savior is evidence. Be it resolved that we celebrate the life, the legacy, and the impact of this woman of God. May the Holy Spirit comfort you, knowing that she rests in the amazing love of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Given under my hand, under the authority of Bishop John F. White, this 12th day of April, in the Lord of our year, 2022. Reverend Donald L. Phillips III, Reverend Dr. Talia Phillips, and the Brown Chapel officers, members, and friends. God bless you, family.
Brothers and sisters, at this time we will be blessed again in song by Sister Maya White. Amen. Amen.
and enough headache. I've had so many ups and downs. Don't know how much more I can take. See, I decided that I cried my last tears yesterday. Either I'm gonna trust you, or I may as well walk away. 'Cause stressing don't make it better. Don't make it better, no way. See, I decided, ooh, that I cried my last tears yesterday.
That's a great lead-in to our scripture for today. Praise God. God is good. He just worked that thing out. Amen. Amen. There is a word from the Lord, family. There is a word from the Lord for this homegoing celebration. Let us pray. Well, God, here we go again. I just ask that your Holy Spirit will continue to comfort. Remind me of what you told me to say. Oh God, strengthen us. Speak to all of us, speak to our hearts, speak down to the nooks and the crannies and places where we didn't even know, oh God, existed. Speak peace, speak comfort, speak your sufficient grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Our word of comfort comes from Matthew, the 11th chapter, verses 28 through 30. And as you were singing, Maya, I was thinking and listening to the words to the song. It's like I just done had enough. I cried my last tear yesterday. Today is going to be better. And there is an invitation to all of us who feel the same way. In Matthew 11, 28 through 30, Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Who knew that we would be gathered here so soon after James? But God's plans are not our plans. His thoughts are not our thoughts. His ways are not our ways. His timing is not our timing. But he is the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy, to walk with us through the valleys of death and lead us to the grace of green pastures and still waters while we are yet grieving. This Matthew scripture, to put it simply, is an invitation to God's amazing grace and tender mercies. It's an invitation written over 2,000 years ago, but the respond by date is still open. It's still ongoing. This invitation was written in red with the blood of Jesus on a Friday we have come to know as Good Friday. It was pinned on an old rugged cross on a hill far away. This one-of-a-kind invitation is for all who have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. It is an appeal for all who are sick and tired of being sick and tired of heartache and yesterdays to come get relief for our pain. This holy solicitation is for all who are exhausted from searching for peace that will last longer than a sleeping pill. This proposition from the cross is for those who cry out for joy for their mourning. This petition is for all of us who have grown weary of trying to fight the devil by ourselves. This open invitation is for anybody and everybody who realizes that in order to live in this world, we just cannot do it by ourselves. This open invitation is for us to maintain our sanity, to learn to forgive ourselves and our enemies, to live as it is in heaven while we living in hell here on earth. We understand we need Jesus. This arm stretch wide invitation is a beckoning for those of us who have come to the knowledge and truth that we cannot do it by ourselves and we need a savior. We need Jesus. We need the lily in the valley. We need a rock in a weary land. We need a river of water in a dry place. The wonderful, the counselor, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Oh, come to me, all who are weary, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. In biblical times, a yoke was something around the neck of an animal that would use to make it submit. And in spiritual terms, it's anything that keeps us in bondage instead of living in the freedom that the cross brings. Lest we forget, amazing grace shall always be my song of praise. For it was grace that bought my liberty. I'll never know just why he came to love me so. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs. I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died for me. How marvelous the grace that caught my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs. I'm sorry, I can't help it. This is Holy Week. Glory to God. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Oh, come to me, all who are weary, and I will give you rest. We have been healed. We have been set free from the power and the penalty of sin and all of its weariness. We have been set free from the yoke of eternal death. Oh, death, where is your victory now? Oh, grave, where is your sting? Death is no longer a burden. It is no longer a yoke of destruction, but it is a necessary means to eternal life. Jesus told us we're going to have troubles as long as we're on this side of Jordan. But be of good cheer, he said, because I've already overcome it. He has come so that we can let go of those yokes that so easily beset us. The unforgiveness, the bitterness, the jealousy, the woulda, coulda, shouldas. Let go of those things that submit us to depression, that cause us to live an unhealthy lifestyle, to miss out on an abundant life because of insecurities or hopes deferred. We got to let go of those things that cause us to submit to making unrighteous choices and turn to the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Take his yoke and learn of him. How do you ask? How do we learn of him? Just like we learn about anything else. We show up. Whether it's a class to learn how to operate Zoom, we show up. Or a self-directed study on the Electoral College, we got to show up. And I'm sure a lot of us showed up for that class after the 2020 election. We can't sleep in class and learn the lesson. We got to stay woke. And when it comes to learning about the Word of God, if we don't pay attention, we could wake up in hell. But there is an invitation to a better place. We just got to show up. We show up when we pray. We show up when we read the word. We show up when we study the word. We show up when we worship. We show up when we love our neighbor as ourselves. We show up when we act like Jesus, when we talk like Jesus, when we walk like Jesus. We show up and he shows out. And during this Holy Week, we call to show up at the cross, lest we forget. At the cross, where I first saw the light. And what? The burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith. I received my sight, and now I'm what? Happy all the day. We got to show up. Jesus had a cross yoke. And because he had a cross yoke, we got a Christ yoke. And we can find rest for our souls. Jada, I know you've had a heavy burden being an only child. And not just these past 2 weeks, but being a caregiver to your mom. And I single-handedly, pretty much, because you are an only child, and thank God you had your children, her grandchildren there. And I witnessed Jada's unconditional love for her mom. I witness her amazing grace toward her. I witness her show of tender mercies as she lovingly stroked her mom and talked to her. And I witness her sweet spirit. The sacrifices that you have made as a daughter are commendable. And certainly, yes. Amen. Very worthy and deserving of that hand clap. And the witness that you are showing your children is a legacy that will live on in this family. They are witnessing the love of a daughter to a mother. just love, unconditional love. They're witnessing God's love, and it's beautiful. And I know your mom was pleased with you, and she received that. Even if she could not tell you, she received it. Mayme Lee Johnson showed up for her children and her grandchildren. She did. She showed up for her neighborhood. She showed up for the lunch bunch. She showed up for her church. She was a longtime member here of Brown Chapel, part of the 8 o'clock crew. And when she came to church, she always sat at one end of the pew. She was quiet in church, but y'all know Mayme was a talker. And when she talked, now I don't know if anybody ever experienced this, but whenever she looked at me, Mayme kind of always had her head down, but her eyes were up like that. Is that how she looked at y'all? And you know what? I was looking at some pictures of her as a little girl, and she had that same pose. I don't know where it came from, but I always thought that was unique. Mayme was family. Y'all know I was adopted into the White family in 1973 through Maxine. And I was good friends with Maxine, but there are uncanny similarities between me and Mayme. The obvious is how she spelled her name, M-A-Y-M-E. That's the first five letters of my name, M-A-Y-M-E-T-T-E. And in addition to that, I have an older sister who was born on July 14th, like Mayme. So we had those similarities. And Mayme always called me Mayme-ette. Mayme knew my name. She knew my name was Mayme, but she called me Mayme-ette. And you know what? I just kind of took it as a term of endearment. I think it was a way for her to connect me to her, Mayme and Ette. So we were connected if she said Mayme-ette. And so, family, as we gather the last mile of the way, we're going to miss Mayme. We're going to miss her wit. We're going to miss her sarcasm. We're going to miss her wisdom. We're going to miss her humor. The lunch bunch is going to miss her. QVC is going to miss her. The casino's going to miss her. A lot of folk going to be missing Mayme. But we thank God that she is no longer bound to a body that had grown weary and weak. Now through death, she has been liberated from the troubles of this world. No more pain, no more suffering, no more crying. Mayme, take your rest. Rest in eternal peace. I can't even imagine what the homegoing's going to look like on the other side. But God, we thank you for her life and her legacy. And for those of us who are left behind to grieve her transition, just show up for the invitation. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find what? Rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. God bless you. Be encouraged.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Reverend Mayme-ette. Amen. I remember that. Hallelujah. Amen. In that scripture, amen. Take my yoke upon you. For my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. And as you shared, that yoke was something that would connect you. And those who were plowing in the field, that they had oxen, they would connect a stronger oxen and yoke them with a weaker oxen, or one that they were training, so that the stronger one could train the other one which way to go. And today in this moment, the question is, are you yoked up to Jesus? Have you been connected so that you are not just saying his name, but allowing him to literally lead and guide your life? And to recognize that when the burden gets too heavy, that you don't have to carry it alone. But he has come. He's already bore the cross for you. Hallelujah. So with eyes closed and heads bowed, just take a personal moment here, eyes closed and heads bowed. Because as we've heard throughout today, Sister Mayme, she already made her choice that Jesus would be her Lord and Savior. And she proved it over the years by being connected. We want to give you an opportunity today. I don't know you personally know what your choice has been, but God knows. And even as we've heard the word declared today, Sister Mayme, her reward is already sure. But you can know today for yourself that you have given your life to Jesus. If you're here under the sound of my voice, and praise God, there are those who are even watching as we stream this service. And you know you want to have a relationship like that with Jesus. You know that you need him to carry you. You need him. We all need him because the Bible says all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But the good news is the gift of Jesus, the gift of what he has done, is everlasting life. If you're here today, you say, no, I want to make up my mind to follow Jesus. I need him in my life. If that's you, you've never made a commitment or a place of faith with Jesus, but you want to do it today, just raise your hand. I'll see your hand. God will see your heart. You may be here and say, you know what, I believe in Jesus, but I need to get back closer. Hallelujah. I need to reconnect with him, allow really to follow him and be yoked up with him the more. That's you. You know, you just need to be a little bit closer. Just raise your hand. Amen. Don't worry about anybody else. The Lord knows what we need. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you right now, Lord. We thank you for the word of encouragement of life that has gone forth. We thank you for your words that still are penetrating, that your yoke is easy and your burdens are light, that we can cast our care upon you. Lord, I say sorry, Lord. Sorry, Lord, for how at times we have tried to do this on our own. Tried to make things and choices on our own. Tried to, even sometimes you were guiding us, but we wanted to do it our own way. We say sorry, Lord. And today we say, God, we want to be connected back to you strong. Come, Holy Spirit, and give us wisdom and insight and guidance. And we're going to choose to listen. We're going to choose to follow. Choose to trust. We thank you, God, that in making that choice, because you already chose us, we thank you in making that choice. You promised to give us a comforter in the Holy Spirit that would help us along the journey. Bless this family, God. Bless these brothers and sisters who have gathered here today. For those who are seeking something, looking for something, let them know that you are the one that can meet their need. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. And I just want to encourage you, you may not have raised your hand, but if you know that was speaking to you, tell somebody. Let somebody know that today I made up my mind. I can do better with him on my side. Hallelujah. I'm putting my faith in Jesus. At this time, we're going to have a service of committal. For indeed, we commit the earthly body. But the good news is she's already with the Lord. Amen. So we call on retired Pastor Hatter to lead us through our service of committal.
Thank you, Pastor Phillips. At this sacred moment, at this sacred moment, this is the time to reflect on what God has already prepared for those who are in Christ. And this sacred moment, as we look back over our lives and the life of our dear sister, we're reminded that man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. He comes up like a flower and withers, and flees like a shadow and continues not. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor but thee, O Lord, who for our sins are justly displeased. Yet, O Lord God, most holy, O Lord, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, deliver us not unto the bitter pains of eternal death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayers, but spare us. Lord, most holy, O God, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, thou most worthy judge eternal, suffer us not at our last hour for any pain of death to fall from thee. Amen. For as much it is pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of the world the soul of our deceased sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, and ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world and the earth and the sea shall give up their dead and those the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty workings whereby he is able to do all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, write from henceforth, blessed are the dead, glory, who die in the Lord. Even so says the Spirit, for they shall rest from their labors. Lord, have mercy on us. Somebody ought to say, Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. And may God keep you now and always.
Amen. As we have had, as you share this homegoing celebration, as we prepare to transition from this place, we are in the arms of the directors. Thank you again for allowing Brown Chapel to serve and to encourage you in this season. And we pray that the prayers that have been prayed would stay with you. Amen. As we declare much prayer, much power. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. Thank you.
children and their children. presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, he is for you. He is for you.